Hey there, and welcome to this email list marketing video. In just a minute, I'm going to introduce you to a snippet of a podcast interview that I did with a guy who's grown email list to over 2 million subscribers, thousands and thousands of customers using leveraged email marketing follow-up and sales conversion strategies. And in the section of the interview, he's going to talk about the specific traffic strategies that he's used to, you know, build that, you know, massive email list. Hi, this is Adam Chandler with NewWorldMarketers.com, which is a podcast and a training hub where I teach leverage digital marketing strategies. You can also click on the subscribe link and hit that little notification button because I also produce a ton of content on this channel showing you how to build profitable, leveraged, lifestyle-friendly online businesses. And this is actually a book. This is a book that I highly recommend to all my marketing friends. It's called 80-20 Sales and Marketing by Perry Marshall, the definitive guide to working less and making more. And the reason why I mention this is because the guy that I'm interviewing, Jonathan Mizell, I met him in person last year. We were both speaking at the same marketing event in Las Vegas, but I've actually known of this guy for years through this book, because in this book, Perry Marshall mentions Jonathan as one of the just top internet marketers in the world and someone who the gurus go to when they want consulting on building massive email lists and, you know, creating autoresponder series that you know, convert tons of customers. So I'm super honored to, you know, to have the pleasure of interviewing this guy. And anytime during this video, click on the links in the description of the video if you want the full interview, which I broke up into two sections. It ended up being 70 minutes long. The first section where he talks about the email marketing or the sales conversion strategies and like autoresponders and some of the other conversion strategies that he used, and then the second part of the interview, which is where he talks about the traffic and list building strategies, which is where this snippet of the interview comes from. So let's go ahead and turn it over to the podcast so we can meet Jonathan and listen to his brilliant traffic and list building strategies.
So a solo ad, the terminology has changed over the last few years. Solo ads now are generally what we think of as standalone ads in the business opportunity or make money or internet marketing or entrepreneurial space.
Right.
And a lot of these list owners in the past we're doing traditional email drops. And that's where I have an offer and I write an ad and then you as the list owner mail it out to your list.
Okay.
And then I get whatever traffic comes in from that. But the problem with that is that for the list owners, they either send you a lot of traffic and you make a lot of money and they want a piece of that money, or nobody clicks on that ad because it's too specific and they don't make any money, or they have to charge you money for the drop and, you know, you didn't get any traffic out of it, or your, you know, traffic came in at $20 a click or some ridiculous thing like that. So the solo ad industry, if we look at it and how it's evolved in the last, say, 5 years, has turned into an industry where you have large list owners who mail out generic emails. They mail them out every single day. And they're very generic. They are, hey, Adam, want to make money on the internet?
Right.
Question mark. You know, click this link and you'll see for yourself how possible this is.
Right.
And then there's a link that, you know, it's not even a doesn't go to a, it doesn't have a URL. It's not like a fancy URL that a good domain or anything. It's usually just a tracking link.
Right.
And then that click goes into a rotator, and you as the person who is, you're not really renting the list, but the person buying the clicks, you're buying these generic clicks. So they're generic make money clicks, or maybe they're generic, if you're lucky, they're generic crypto clicks or generic network marketing clicks. And the reason that that works for the list owner is because they don't have to find one person to rent the whole list. And if more clicks come through than they've sold, you know, it's a big problem for these list owners. So they sign up a bunch of people to buy clicks, and then they do one blast or two blasts a day. And then all that traffic goes into the rotator. And then if you're part of that rotator, part of that buy, that group, or really if you're just buying the clicks, you get some of that traffic. So, and that's not bad. You know, it's still email. It's not as targeted as you writing your own ad. It's not as targeted as, you know, even a specific offer to promote some particular thing or some particular program. But it's driven by email, so generally the fraud is pretty low if it's a good seller, and it's generally real people, and you can usually use that to build your list, that kind of traffic, if you're in that space. I generally prefer a company like, not, you know, it's not the only one, pardon me, but we use a company called Archimax. And Archimax will let you write your own ad and actually send it out. You control the subject line. Okay. You can control the from field. You control all the copy and all the links. Now, you're going to pay, you know, I think the solo ads, or not the solo ads, but the drops, they start at about $1,000 through Archimax. And through other list brokers, they can, you know, start at, you know, $2,000, $2,000. If you want Publishers Clearinghouse, which we've worked with in the past, I think their minimum is $10,000 or $15,000.
Wow.
Or Cool Savings or My Points or someone like that. But you're going to own and control the copy. Now, there's something, it's not really in the middle, but it's in the middle of the price. There's also a new kind of email ad that we use most of the time now, at least when we're starting, and that's a sponsorship ad. So you can buy a banner ad in an email, or you can buy a text ad in an email, or you can buy a blurb. It looks like maybe content, but it's really an ad. You're paying for it.
Right.
You know, it's 5 lines or 7 lines of text with a URL. And something like that might only cost $500 or $600. So there's different ways. On the low end, you've got generic, I want to buy clicks and I just want 100 of them. And then on the high end, you've got, I want Publishers Clearinghouse to mail out my amazing offer to their, you know, 25 million people, and I'm willing to pay a ton of money for it.
Right.
And then you've got kind of stuff in the middle. And then there's a completely different part of that, which is where you don't pay anything for the ad, but where, and this is kind of how we started this whole conversation, where you go to one of your competitors and you say, hey, I've got this new offer, or I'm doing a split test, and I would love for you to help me out. I'll help you out next time you have one. And I'll also pay you 100% commission, or I'll guarantee you, you know, I'll guarantee you $1,000 if you mail your whole list of sales. And then that way, you know, you're getting the creative and the copy that you want to go out. Because if you think about it, you know, the process of buying your product, let's say it's a weight loss product, it doesn't start with someone clicking your order link. It starts with the prospect waking up, you know, every morning for a couple of years and being not happy with themselves.
Right.
It happens when someone says something mean to them, or their wife or husband doesn't look at them the same way. That's where the process occurs that makes them think they need to make a change. And then finally, your ad comes along. There's a great thing. I know you've heard this before. It said, great marketing is when you join the conversation already going on in the prospect's head, right? So now you're able to join that conversation, that conversation of shame, of, we're just looking at the weight loss thing right now, but shame, of embarrassment, of fear, of pain. You can't sleep. You have joint pain. You can't pick stuff up. There's this huge, giant ball of problems that happens. And what I do as a marketer, and what I like to do and what I teach, is if it's a ball of yarn that's like the problems, I like to start picking at that ball and pulling those strings out and making that pain great enough so that the person's going to take some action to try to overcome it. And then there's a lot more to it, but you know, where that unraveling starts is in my subject line. It's in my teaser ad. It's in my landing page. It's in my squeeze. Wow. It's in my first follow-up. And that's why I prefer that kind of email drop as opposed to, the kind where it's like, hey, if you need to lose weight, click here, you know, lose weight now. I mean, you know, or if you're in joint pain, I mean, there's starting to be more specific solo ads in the health space, but mostly it's, if you want to make money, click here, right. Because that's what it is. You can sell anything, you know, almost anything, if with the money thing. I mean, you can sell all these biz op things, you can sell investment stuff, you can sell, I don't know. One of my friends says, we're all opportunity seekers. We're just seeking an opportunity that's different from the people next to us.
Right.
You know, he wants an opportunity to get skinny. She wants an opportunity to get married.
Right.
He wants an opportunity to, I don't know, to become a world-class fisherman or skier or whatever it is you're selling.
You know, that was just about a 9-minute snippet of the 70-minute interview. Like I said, I had to break it up into two sections. Click the link in the description of this video. You'll see the links to both of the blog posts that house section 1 and section 2 of this highly, highly valuable interview, which is all about driving traffic, building email lists, and converting sales with email marketing. Leave me a comment. Make sure you're subscribed to this channel. Leave me a comment if you found it valuable or if you have any questions about using email marketing, because I definitely plan on interviewing this guy again. And if we got a bunch of questions, about email marketing, we can put them in front of him and actually do another podcast interview with him answering your questions. So leave me a comment below, like this video, share it if you found it valuable. I look forward to talking to you again real soon.